I am a very optimistic person. I believe that everything works the way it should. I believe that negative things that happen to us is almost always an opportunity to learn a lesson. And then the good things are definitely things that when you hope for comes your way. So generally, I just have a positive outlook on my daily experiences and the things that I do. So it reflects very much in my design aesthetic. I always have a positive story behind my collections. I have a few role models in my life. I mean, I look up to my mother a lot. She has taken very good care of us. Coming from a not so rich home, she made sure that she gave us good education and we were well fed. And we're here, so I look up to her. She's very hardworking. She's very consistent with her work, very diligent. And these are virtues that I'm still learning on a daily basis. In the industry, I look up to a few brands in Ghana and in Africa, and actually also in the world. In Ghana, I look up to a brand like Christy Brown. She's a woman, it's a women's wear brand. And I feel that they are doing a lot of the things that I'm looking at doing. Some I'm already doing. I look up to them very much. In Africa, I actually look around, I look at what people are doing, and I'm quite inspired by the industry growing in Africa. A lot of luxury brands selling the African story and letting the world know that so many beautiful things can come from Africa. My mom had been very supportive. I mean, I remember when I came out of university, I read insurance in university, and then I decided that I was going to follow my passion instead of perhaps working in finance. And she encouraged me because she's been very entrepreneurial all her life, and she believes that once you're passionate about something and you set your mind to it, it can actually be as good as anything else that you could do. So even leaving insurance, business administration, and starting my own fashion brand, she was very supportive in the beginning. She gave me some soft loans. She actually helped me put up my production facility. And, that's to the extent that she has been supportive to the brand. The question will be a question of leadership.
I see.
Yes, because running a fashion brand is not just about creativity. It's actually also about human management and social intelligence. And yes, that has been one of the areas that I'm eagerly seeking to improve. How to work with the team, how to work with the machinists, and understand the differences of personality. Because it is only with a very solid team that you can be able to project and spread the message of the brand. So that's one of the things that I would want to have a conversation about. Right now, I would say finance, definitely. Because we are at a point in the life of the brand that we have some brand awareness. People know us for what we do. I think we are at the level where we need to scale up and meet the demands that we are attracting. So definitely finance. I think that a bit of administrative support, because if you're looking to scale up, the odds are different from working in a very small brand. So those two things, administrative support and then finance. Wow. So it's very interesting. I almost think that I was led into it by the powers there be. I remember when I finished national service, there's something called national service in Ghana, where you finish your tertiary education and you have a year where you work for the country in different places where government places you in different industries or businesses for you to work. During that time, I realized that I had a lot of time on my hands and I was thinking of what I could do. And again, during that time, I had a lot of friends who were already working in the arts, in fashion, in retail, fashion retail, and all of those things. And there were just so many people who were inspiring me from different angles. I had friends who were fashion designers. I had friends who were just tailors. I had friends who were working in fashion brands. And even before then, I'd always known that I was creative, but I didn't think that I could start a career in fashion just yet. I had thoughts of making some money in finance, and then in my later years, just invest in a fashion brand or create a fashion brand. But it just caught up with me around the time when I was thinking of what to do next. But I actually decided to start fashion. I started it off with a fashion show. Even when I hadn't gone to fashion school or knew anything about fashion, I just started with a very small fashion show, and I enjoyed it thoroughly. And that was when I enrolled in a fashion school. And then right after fashion school, I started this brand.
And now, what are your two top desires?
Wow, my two top desires is to be a very wealthy man. No, that's just by the way. But I want to see Atto Tetteh grow into a global luxury brand, a brand that is known everywhere in the world, and it's actually very known in Africa. Mm-hmm. That's my topmost desire, and I also desire into go diversifying my portfolio into other lifestyle ventures. I haven't really thoroughly thought about that, but I definitely know that it's not going to just be fashion. It's going to be interior decor, mm-hmm. and other things in the art.
And what are the geographical regions you are most interested in for your expansion?
So the geographical regions that I'm interested in for my expansion is Africa. The first is Africa. I believe that as Africans, we need to consume what we produce. We need to believe in ourselves before we ask other people to believe in us. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the time when young brands are emerging from Africa, they have their eyes on the European market and the Asian and American markets. But I think that there's a lot of room for growth in Africa itself. For example, you can be a fashion brand in Ghana and have outlets in Kenya. You can have outlets in Cote d'Ivoire, South Africa, and Nigeria. And because it's who we are, these people will even understand it more.
Sure.
Sustainability means ethical fashion for me because of the role that the career that I'm on. I see a sustainability in the fashion sense. And in the fashion sense, it means that you running an ethical fashion line where welfare is paramount. When I say welfare of the people that you work with, welfare of your suppliers, and all other stakeholders. And then also, it also means a reduction of waste. When you talk about sustainability, you are looking at doing things positively so that people who come after you will not have to deal with the errors or the mismanagement that you have put in place. It is really and truly fairness for me, and being very honest and working in love. If all these virtues are in place, I believe that every organization can work sustainably. I believe that really and truly the fight towards sustainability is really a fight to encourage honesty, because a lot of people will end up paying some lip service in the guise of sustainability. Sustainability is really being honest with the people that you work with, the people that consume your products, and then all other stakeholders.
How deeply are you connected with your supply chain?
To an appreciable level. I say this because in our supply chain, we have some artisans who actually produce fabrics for us. We also have some fabric traders that we just buy fabrics from. And also basically we have people that we work with through the production of our pieces. And for the people that produce, the artisans that produce fabrics and other items for us, we know them, we visit them, we have connections with them in terms of exchanging ideas on how exactly we want our products to be. For those who we just buy fabrics from, we also know them, we build a relationship with them. One thing that we do as a brand is we love to buy from specific people rather than just buying from just the open market. So we know them, we speak with them, and we do business with them. Most of our supply chain is based in Ghana. We are located in Accra. Accra, not Legon, a suburb of Accra. And most of our suppliers are in a market called Makola. Some of our suppliers are also in the northern part of Ghana, precisely Tamale, and also in the central region of Ghana. So they are dotted around, but yeah, most of them are in Ghana, and it's quite easy to travel around Ghana, so we know them and we interact with them.
What's the situation in Ghana in terms of social responsibility? Have your suppliers confirmed that they pay their workers fairly? How does it work over there?
Africa, by nature, is actually built on sustainability. So sustainability is really true and truly embedded in Africans. From reusing our clothes, from making to measure, from doing handmade products, it's a lifestyle. With globalization and in recent times, a lot of us have drifted away from sustainable practices and copying others cultures that are not necessarily sustainable. But one thing that we all agree is, because of globalization, the world has come to a point where we all agree that sustainability is the way to go now. So really and truly, for Ghanaians, it is a call to go back to how what we already know and how we used to live. And I think that if this is communicated right, there's a high level of illiteracy when it comes to the artisans. Most of them are not necessarily literate. So we need tools to be able to get them to be on the full wing of understanding what sustainability is, because it is something that we've lived with, and it's really second to nature to us as Africans.
This conversation was really inspiring. So what about suggesting to people that would like to take your path, so young designers like you, what would you recommend?
I will recommend that if you're running a fashion brand or you are running any brand, sustainability should be very high on your agenda. But also advise that you be confident in your craft. You should be very diligent with your work, because you have to be consistent. You will not be able to run a good brand without consistency. So these are the three things that I will leave anybody who wants to start a brand in the arts. Any things that I will never do again? That's quite a difficult one. Anything that I will never do again? I will never say never. One thing that I know about the person is times change, and for every situation, it demands a new approach or a different approach. So I won't say that I'm from Ghana or I'm African, so everything I'm going to do is only going to be inspired by Africa. I'm definitely open to new cultures, open to new ideas. So I think that's the one thing I'll never do. Never say never.
An innovation existing or in your dreams that could aid your business or industry in general?
So I think it's existing, but it's one of the things that I would love to do in a few years, is to have an incubation project where fashion talents or creative talents onboard onto my collections, where I believe that it will be an opportunity for them to learn hands-on, and then it will also be good for the brand in terms of bringing different ideas and different cultures on. It's one thing that is really dear on my heart. I would love definitely to create a space where young people can explore their creativity and also learn from Atto Tetteh.